Welcome in to Wildcat Sports Talk. Let's join Adam Webb and Tim Brandstetter now.
Well, welcome in once again to another edition of Big Blue Nation's Best Kept Secret. We are Wildcat Sports Talk. I want to thank you guys for tuning into the show. As we've got a packed show tonight, and of all the shows we've done, this might be the most packed show we've ever done.
Definitely.
Yeah. So my name's Adam.
My name's Tim,
and we are Wildcat Sports Talk. Make sure you check us out. Go ahead and click that share button for us if you don't care. Just share it out to all your friends and family, because this is one of those shows tonight that you are going to definitely want to listen to. And if you are listening on 106.3, the big one, this is a show because we thought, you know, in lieu of the SEC tournament, we're going to be talking a lot of that, okay, this week. We're going to be down in Nashville.
Right.
So, you know, we're going to be talking a lot about that. So we figured this show, we can turn our head to football for a little bit. I think everybody needs to turn over to football for a little while. So we're going to talk about some former players that played in the days of old and, you know, just see what we can do. All right. Let's see who we can talk to. So, yeah, so we got a couple of guests that are going to be lined up. So that should be a lot of fun, right?
Oh, it's going to be a whole lot of fun, man. When you talk about Kentucky guests, Kentucky former players, it really don't get much better than this show tonight.
And Q says his two favorite people. Well, buddy, we
thanks
definitely
a lot, Q. We
definitely appreciate
that.
You. That's for sure. You don't even know.
You're the man. You're the man. And you are going to enjoy this show, Q, and you need to tell everybody to watch.
Yeah, make sure you tell everyone to watch. I mean,
I'm not doing this show till more people get on.
I mean, that's the thing.
This
you
is
know,
ridiculous.
This is unbelievable.
We're going to share it out, guys. Everybody's going to share it out because nobody's watching, and this is going to be one of the best shows we've had. I mean, big time Kentucky football players on this show.
That's exactly right, and we're kind of just waiting on one to come on right now, but we do have a couple of others that will be on as well. Like I said, you don't want to miss it. You don't want to miss it. So if you are out there right now and you're like, you know what, I want to watch some stuff. All right, you want to watch some good stuff, right? Well, this is the stuff to watch, right?
That's right, man. That is right. And you guys are going to enjoy this. This is going to be a treat because I know most of you guys like the same players that I like from Kentucky football history, and you're going to like these guys. It's awesome. I know we've already advertised it. We've already told you guys that we're having, you know, Jalen Whitlow. We're having Andre Woodson, and it's going to be great. And we've even got a surprise guest or two.
Yeah, I mean, this is something that, I mean, let me just tell you. We've got, first of all, everybody knows, we've kind of been pushing this all week, but first we've got former quarterback Jalen Whitlow. He's going to be on the show. And then, later on this hour, we'll have Andre Woodson. Everybody loves Andre Woodson. And guess what? We've got some other guests, too. And those are ones that, like...
Oh, they're huge.
They're huge.
They're huge.
So, I mean, I'm just telling you guys...
But, you know, Mark gets it. Mark says, hey, guys, love you all. BBN. And then we also got Derek, who said, I've been looking forward to this. This is the Super Bowl of all shows.
See, that's what it's all about. I mean, that's really honestly what it's all about. So I want to thank you guys for tuning in. And we're going to talk to Jalen here in just a little bit. Tim, can you take over for a minute so I can see if he's got any issues?
Yeah, man, you go ahead and check it out. But guys, we're excited. I mean, we're pumped up because, you know, it's not far away from the SEC tournament. We're you know, we found out really late notice that we're going to be able to make it down to watch the Cats play you know, in the SEC tournament in Nashville. I've never been to a SEC tournament. I haven't. I mean, as old as I am and as many Kentucky games as I've been to, I've been to all home games and a couple Tennessee games, but this is my first SEC tournament that I'm going to get to go to, so I'm super pumped up about going to Nashville, and I am super pumped up about this show because, man, I am still to this day a huge fan of these guys, and whenever I get a chance to talk to them, it makes you a little nervous, man, because you're like, I remember all the memories I had of these guys. I mean, I had some great memories watching them play, and, you know, it's exciting to have them on the show.
Well, without further ado, let's go ahead and bring on Mr. Jalen Whitlow. Jalen, how you doing?
Good, man. How are y'all?
Doing great. So
look at that shirt, man. He's
yeah,
looking
look
good.
Yeah, man.
I had to do it, man.
That's awesome. That's
good
awesome
stuff. That's good stuff. So, Man, first of all, let's check in with you and tell us how you've been, man. I mean, it's been a while since we've seen you. So how's everything been going for you?
Good, man. I can't really complain. As you know, just released the book about a month ago. You know, still coaching quarterbacks, been doing that, you know, for 4 years now, probably going on five now. It's good, man. So, you know, can't really complain.
Man, I saw where you released a book, and I was like, we have got to get him on the show. Because, I mean, I've been a sports writer for 20 years, and I've always thought about writing a book. And I saw that, and I was like, man, a dude that wore the blue and white for Kentucky, he's got a book. We got to check this out. So tell us how long it took you to write that book, man, and give us a little bit of an idea of what it's about.
Yeah, so, man, I started writing it. I was, you know, home. You know, coronavirus, and, you know, we all got quarantined back in March. And I just started typing, you know, just kind of just typing thoughts. I had an idea on how I, you know, wanted to do some things. I started to structure it. My goal was to kind of create a small pamphlet of, you know, of just my ideas about college and, you know, being prepared in college and whatnot. So what happened was, you know, I got egged on by a lot of people that I, you know, family and whatnot. So I decided to, you know, I coached this past football season in Marietta, Georgia at Sprayberry High School. We lost in the second round of playoffs. And I mean, immediately after the game, that next day, I was, you know, back on the laptop, man, and, you know, typing some things out. So, you know, it was something that I, you know, been wanting to do for a couple months, and I, you know, decided to go ahead and do it. You know, I think it's really something that could help, you know, high school and collegiate athletes big time, man. I really do. It's something that, you know, I just think it's important in today's time. You know, it just helps the student athletes get a grasp of what to look for, how to manage certain situations, what's important outside of football and being a student athlete, because contrary to popular belief, I think that the education part is not the most important, you know, part of about, you know, about being in college. I think it's just about learning, you know, learning yourself, setting yourself up for the future, bettering yourself personally. It's a lot of things. So I put a whole bunch of stuff in there, recruiting information. It's a whole bunch of stuff in that book. You know, it's a short book, but it's also, you know, very, very detailed and to the point.
I was going to say, basically a book that you would have liked to have had going into college to get you prepared.
100%. If I had that book, and if some of my teammates had that book, we would have had a totally different outlook on what was to come. Totally different, you know, probably changed our trajectory, you know, on some things. You know, not that what happened to me was bad, you know, being in college and playing Division I football. That was great. You know, a lot of people don't get that opportunity. So I was lucky to get that. But just, you know, the way we handle day-to-day business, relationships, social life, networking, you know, even the academic part, the athletic part, how to be a great teammate, you know, how to talk to people, you know, about certain things, how to kind of get the most out of your situation. It definitely would have helped us in a lot of areas.
Yeah. So, you know, we, by the way, if you're just joining us here on 106.3, the big one, want to thank you guys for tuning in. We've got former UK quarterback Jalen Whitlow on with us. We're talking about his book. Now, how can you find, how can one out there maybe acquire the book? How can they get it?
Man, I see y'all showing the highlights from the Alabama State game, man. It's kind of got me watching it. But you can find the book on Amazon.com. You just type in the title, Prepared, The Guide to a Successful Collegiate Experience. It's for athletes and parents. So on Amazon, you can get, I got the Audible version coming, but right now we have the physical paper copy, and we have the ebook, you know, Kindle ebook version. So, like I said, simple, easy read. I've been sending out signed copies. You know, I've been having people that I know order copies. So it's been fun, man. It's been a, you know, something different. You know, I always want to do something outside of football, and I still have things outside of football that I want to do that I'm working on, even further out of football than even this book. Out of athletics totally. So just some things that I kind of wanted to do, man. So I, you know, just decided to do it.
That's awesome, man.
That's, yeah. But Jalen, tell us a little bit about your time in Kentucky. I mean, you know, You were talking about the game there, and I like I said, we've got a million different highlights on here that we've been playing. But
yeah, Braylon, I remember the South Carolina game, man. You kind of blew up in that game. I think it might have been your sophomore season. I think you were credited for 3 touchdowns. Had a big game.
Yeah, so I definitely remember my freshman year. You remember I came in with due to injuries, I came into the game, South Carolina game at Kentucky in Commonwealth Stadium, now Kroger Field. But my sophomore year, we played okay on offense, had a chance to win the game. Obviously, should have won it. We just honestly, man, now that I'm a coach, just looking back, we just didn't know how to win. To be honest with you, now they know how. You know, the system has been in place. Coach Dukes has done a great job. Now that the program is in a place where it's gaining traction, the kids know how to pull out wins in tight games. We just didn't necessarily have that. We had a lot of young guys playing, but my time in Kentucky was great. I wouldn't trade it for anything. Those guys like DeMarco Robinson right there blocking for me. I actually talked to him not too long ago. talked to Marco not too long ago. He actually lived in Atlanta as well. Some of these guys I'm throwing the ball to, man. So, I talked to some of the old linemen not too long ago. I talked to Raymond Sanders, as you see right here. Actually talked to him a couple weeks ago. So my time in Kentucky was great. I wouldn't change for anything. I met a lot of great people. It's Barb Denniston, who works, academics, who helps with the athletes. Great relationship. I talked to Morgan Newton on the phone last week. So it's just, I wouldn't trade it for anything. I made a lot of great relationships there.
Yeah, that's awesome. That's awesome. Yeah. So, we also, and by the way, one of the things that I note with your game is that you are a true dual threat quarterback. I mean, we don't get a whole lot of those at Kentucky, which is something I think you kind of was the trendsetter, though, because then we get guys like Terry Wilson and others that can kind of do that. But I mean, you really came in and showed what dual threat quarterbacks could do for Kentucky.
Yeah, it's something that I saw myself as more of a pocket guy. Now that didn't really manifest in the offense that we ran my sophomore year. Freshman year manifested a little bit more because we were more of a pro style type offense. Actually, Coach Randy Sanders was the offensive coordinator. I talked to him quite often. Saw him not too long, a couple of years ago. I was coaching a quarterback in South Carolina. We went up to East Tennessee State where he's the head coach, and my quarterback was taking a visit there. So got a great relationship with him and his family. So, yeah, just being a dual threat, man, it's kind of just happened. I guess it was my game in that particular offense. I like to see myself as a guy who a kind of a chameleon type quarterback who can play in all systems. And that's how I train my quarterbacks. Now that's how I teach them. Learn everything you can learn, have a well-rounded game, and kind of high school helped me get the kind of dual threat tag because we ran – a lot of, spread option type stuff. And I was running the ball quite a bit, actually played a little receiver my senior year. But yeah, man, now Terry Wilson was a great quarterback. Steven Johnson was a great quarterback. Those guys are great dual threat guys as well. Patrick Toles was a great dual threat guy. We had a lot of, it's been a lot of good quarterbacks, come through Kentucky. It's just now I think, football is in a place now where kids are coming out of high school super prepared, with a lot of quarterback trainers and whatnot. So now they, these kids are well prepared, and I like the hire that Kentucky made at OC. I think it's going to make a difference.
Yeah. So tell us about that. I mean, do you know what do you know about him? I mean, do you think he's going to be a kind of a difference maker, as you said, at Kentucky?
Yeah, I think he will. So I've always, since Sean McVay has been been with the Rams. I've been studying his offense, the outside zone, boot, naked, play action thing. And we've done a lot of that where, the schools that I coached, and I was the offensive coordinator in South Carolina, we did a lot of some of that stuff. So as much as we can with high school athletes. But just from him coming from that tree, I think he's coming from like the Mike Shanahan tree. I think it'll be great. I think the run game will be great. I think the thing with that offense is they are so they are scientists when it comes to just the play action game, which is where I think Kentucky want to be. You know, I don't think Kentucky want to be a high volume passing team on offense. I think they want to be more of a, you know, run play action RPO type offense, just in my opinion, from what I've seen. Right. And I think that's what, you know, kind of Coach Dukes want, in my opinion, and just by the way he recruits. So I think he'll definitely, you know, I think the hire was a great hire. I think he'll bring some expertise to the play action passing game.
That sounds awesome, man. Just real quick, we're running out of time, but I just wanted to – it seems like, you know, a lot of times you see players transfer and things. You don't know what happens. You don't know what's going on. But it seems like there's no kind of hard feelings at all between you and the UK and the coaching staff or any of that. I mean, you're wearing the blue today. You're on our show. So just tell us about that.
Yeah, I don't have any hard feelings for anybody. You know, I don't hold anything. You know, it was a decision made, you know, when I was there that was made. And I made a decision that I thought was best for me. So, you know, I don't have any hard feelings for anybody. You know, Coach Dukes, you know, was great to us, you know, and actually my roommate left the same time I left. AJ McGree ended up playing at South Florida. You know, he was showing us some of those clips earlier, but we like Coach Dukes. I love the strength coaching staff, Coach Edmund, you know, and I mean, I liked it, man. So I don't have any hard feelings for nobody. I haven't spoken to him. You know, those guys in a minute, but as men, man, you know, time heals all, you know, and then it's really nothing to heal. Like, we just made, you know, decisions that was best for us at the time, you know what I'm saying? So it wasn't, you know, anything, you know, to have really hard feelings about, you know, and I, you know, some of those guys you see, like Cody Quinn just picking up the block punt, spoke to him not too long ago about the book. So, you know, it was my experience at Kentucky was great. More of the story. Like, I enjoyed every minute of it, and I got great relationships with those guys.
That's good to hear, man.
That's good stuff. That's good stuff. Well, man, tell them about your book one more time and where they can get it, and let them know.
All right. So the book is Prepared, The Guide to a Successful Collegiate Experience. It's on Amazon.com. Type in the title. We'll type in the main title and type in my name. And it's, you know, it's something that can really, really help a student athlete out there. So if you know a student athlete or you listen to this and you are a student athlete, I think it's a great, great read that may take you a day or two, maybe three, depending on your pace. It's something that can really, really help touch on a lot of different things. It's something that can kind of change your perspective on a lot of different things. You know, I just think, you know, it's one of those things that I think should be read by every college football team in fall camp. You know, I think it's one of those type of books, not really like, you know, hyping myself up, but I think it's something that need to be heard. It need to be read. It need to be dissected in a way. So, you know, I encourage everybody to go get that, you know, so it's just something that can really help, you know.
Say that again. Sorry about that. That was my fault. I played something inadvertently.
No, you're good.
But you're right. Go ahead.
Yeah, it's definitely a must read for, you know, all those guys coming to college for sure.
Oh yeah, 100%. You know, and somebody may get it and not like it, but I guarantee you that person can take something from it and apply it. It's applicable knowledge.
Right.
Well, we want to thank you for joining us here again on Wildcat Sports Talk. We'd love to have you back sometime to talk a little more football. Again, thanks so much. And Jalen, go Cats.
All right, I appreciate you all.
Thanks a lot, man.
Go. All right, take care. All right, guys. There you have it, Mr. Jalen Whitlow.
Awesome stuff, man.
Joining us. I mean, I'm telling you.
Awesome stuff. And we're just getting started.
Oh, yeah. All right. But unlike the song, this ain't it.
No, this is not it.
No, not at all. Hey, don't forget, Donovan Storm's got you covered on life, home, auto, workman's comp, motorcycle. I mean, he's going to cover you.
Right.
All right.
Right.
Go see him. He's located in Corbin, next to L&N Federal Credit Union in the Union Plaza Shopping Center. When we return, we got Andre Woodson. He's on the Wildcat Sports Talk clock. That's here, right, on Big Blue Nation's Best Kept Secret. We are Wildcat Sports Talk. Girl, don't lie.
just to save my feelings.
Hey, are you looking for a new phone or to repair your old device? Go see them over at One Stop Phone Shop. That's right. They can literally save you hundreds of dollars on a new device or to repair your old device. Now, everything they do on site, whether it be Android or iPhone repairs, are usually within 1 hour. Stop by today. See them over in Middlesboro, located at 1507 Highway 25 in Middlesboro, Kentucky. You can also give them a call. Call them up 606-302-7005.
Do more. Enjoy more. Expect more from your internet experience. Kinetic by Windstream is delivering enhanced speed and reliability for homes and businesses around the country. We've made major investments in our network in your community. We're lighting the way to advanced capabilities and more opportunities. Stream seamlessly, surf securely, game victoriously, and connect to great offers for work or home at Windstream.com.
If you're thinking about making the switch to Windstream, you can do it today. That's right. Just $37 a month and you'll get the fast internet you've been dreaming of. And the best part, you sign up with me, you're going to get a $100 credit and 30 days to try it out risk-free. No money down. What have you got to lose? Call me today, 606-309-1673. And let me set you up. That's 606-309-1673.
Joining us now on Wildcat Sports Talk, ladies and gentlemen, I'm excited about this one. The absolute legend. Joining us now is the Andre Woodson. How you doing?
I'm great, guys. Thanks for having me.
Hey, listen, first of all, it's an absolute honor to have you on. I know this guy right here is a huge fan of yours, and of course I am as well. I mean, look. Some of the best memories were of you there at Kentucky, and you're involved with just about all of those. So we really it's an honor to have you on.
That's amazing. I really appreciate that.
Yeah.
Yeah, man, I've just got to jump in and say something, but yeah, definitely one of my favorite all-time Cats, basketball, football, either one. I mean, just the memories, man. I mean, I was a huge fan, big-time fan. Adam, if you don't care, grab that right there behind you.
What's that?
I want to show him
that. Oh, yeah.
Me and Adam, we collect a lot of UK memorabilia, and we got a big bulk of stuff, and I was like, I don't care what you get out of that stuff. I'm getting that. That's mine.
Yeah, there you go.
That's terrific. Seriously, guys, I'm honored and humbled. That means a lot.
So how you been doing? How you been doing these days?
I'm doing well. I work for Amazon in public relations. I travel around the country, do a lot of really cool stuff, and my boys are keeping me active. They're super rambunctious and mischievous, but life is going really well.
That's great, man. That's good to hear, man.
Yeah, that's awesome. Now, tell us a couple, just real quick. I mean, you know, your time at Kentucky. I mean, you know, what are some of you as a player, you know, as a former player, some of your fondest memories?
Oh my goodness, fondest memories. I would certainly say it's the rich culture and tradition of the fan base. Obviously, Amazon or Kentucky has historically had, I would say, arguably the best fan base of any university program in the country. I mean, every game that we would attend, I mean, they showed up in herds. I mean, it was just tons of people there supporting at all times. And that to me was so remarkable given our track record. You know, we were trying to overcome so many hurdles, and we had a lot of obstacles with scholarship limitations and trying to get guys to buy into the program, and really had challenges recruiting players from different states. And you know, but still, yeah, we'd go to stadiums and there was that sea of blue always packing a section. And it was remarkable to see. It really was. It's probably one of my fondest memories of just seeing the incredible, showing of fans to support us game in and game out.
You know, Andre, when I first became a Kentucky fan when I was just real little, we had a lot of tough seasons. I mean, a lot of tough seasons. You know, we kept going, man. I remember my first game as a kid, I went to Tennessee and watched us get beat like 49-0, and I was still a huge fan. You know, I still wanted to watch every game, every second. But when you came along, man, you're part of that culture change, that group that came in and was like, hey, you know what, we can win. You made it exciting, man, and I can't help but go back to that 2006, you know, spring when you were in that quarterback battle. I mean, people were like, oh, you know, Curtis Pooley's going to start. And then all of a sudden, man, you went to work, and it's like you just took over, man. I mean, kind of describe what was your mindset then.
Well, I tell you what, a supporting cast makes a significant difference, doesn't it? With having a healthy group of players certainly helps a player of sort of my ability amplify your abilities because, you know, the season before I didn't have a Dickey Lyons. Keenan Burton was injured majority of the season. Jacob Tammy had, you know, severe shoulder injuries. We didn't have Stevie Johnson. So several players who weren't out there. Raphael Little was kind of, you know, he was handling the burden of the load and Mr. All-Purpose Everything. I think he was like ranked third in the country behind Reggie Bush and somebody else. And, you know, we had a multitude of injuries that season before. I think we had like 37 surgeries at the conclusion of the season, wow. Which is astonishing. It's baffling to hear that many people were injured. And then the season, you know, leading into the 06, you know, we started to build some chemistry. The guys were healthy in the off season. We started to, you know, we worked on cohesion, just kind of like getting in the weight room and getting on 7-on-7 and doing a lot of drills together and started to build this really good bond. And you felt something was different about it. And, in addition to that, Randy Sanders, who was the quarterback coach, came on the team. I mean, he was instrumental in my development and understanding of the system and being a leader. And I certainly give him a lot of credit to my overall success because he really pushed me to a different level. And, you know, we were able to obviously develop into more mature men. But, you know, the outcome was quite evident that, you know, we just needed some healthy players on the field to compete.
That's awesome.
Well, I told you we have some surprises for you, and I've got one first one right here that I'd like to show you. First of all, this is a play that I'm sure you'll remember well, so I'll go ahead and kick this off for you.
Obviously, they felt because of the rush Clemson was getting, they could get it by, and they could screen pass on the fake. And now Woodson going deep, man, wide open, caught! DeMario!
Love it.
5 touchdown Kentucky.
Yes. Yeah.
You know what's funny about that play is it's actually a single high read, and the entire week Randy Sanders was stressing to me, do not throw it down the middle of the field if there is a single high safety. Do not read it. Do not read it. Do not read it. And only in two high are you supposed to read the middle field. He's called a mofo, middle open, field open. Like, he'll actually bend it down the middle of the seam. And I even recognize it was single high, but yet that fake that we sold it so hard, I don't know if you can tell, but the safety comes screaming down. And as soon as I looked up, I mean, my natural instinct was throw it down the middle. And I remember Randy still on the sideline saying, why in the hell did you throw it to that? You know, I mean, you can't help it. The guy bit on it. But the entire week, you know, we were training ourselves never to throw it down the middle of the field if that safety's in there. And he still bit on that thing really hard. And there goes DeMario Ford wide open in the middle of the field.
Well, speaking of which, say hello to DeMario Ford. How you doing?
What's up, man?
My guy.
How you going? Man,
I was just talking. I'm great, man. How about yourself?
I'm doing good, man. Long time.
I know it's been a minute. Last time I was on, I got the pleasure of talking to Raph, who I haven't in a while. And I was just like, I haven't talked in a minute. We all, you know, we all live in life, man. And I'm recently back in Lexington now. And
that's awesome.
So you guys told me, I was actually thinking unless I just assumed something different. But I did not know you were on. It was so great to see you, brother.
Yeah, man. It's so great to see you. Seriously, I'm so happy to hear you doing well. I was literally watching that play, and I'm like, look at this guy, DeMario Ford.
Well, so
hey, it's so crazy. Hey, Dre, I'm sorry.
Go ahead, man. Go ahead.
No, I was saying last time I was on the show, I was explaining that the Hamlin kid, the Hamlin guy hit so hard on the run, and I didn't expect me to be going in the middle of the field.
I know.
So by the time I got to him, he was still coming towards me. So I was like, I ain't that slow, you know what I mean? But that was awesome.
Well, So Andre, I told you, like I said, I have more than just that. All right. I've got another memory that I'd like to share with you for just a second. And this is one that is a cat memory all across the world. And here, so here we go.
To the Kentucky 43. Woodson from the gun, play fake, step it up. He's throwing deep down the near sideline. He's in the
You know what's funny is I swear I have like a backstory for every single one of these plays. Like this one, that play right there is hilarious because that was actually the third time we ran that concept in the game. The first time I ended up throwing Stevie right before halftime. I don't know if you guys had saw that, but we ended up missing. It was by like inches. It hit him right on his fingertips. He was wide open on the sideline. And they were running cover two again. And then the second time was actually about two or three plays before that play. Yeah. And I tried to hit Jacob Tammy down the seam. And this time when I hit Stevie, the safety was in the same coverage. They're in cover two. But this time he bit on Tammy because he saw him bending down the seam. And he actually comes screaming down. And as he does, I don't know if you could tell in that replay, I'm actually staring at Tammy, but when I saw him react, then I kind of peek over to look at Stevie, and as I'm throwing it, the only thing in my head I'm thinking is, please don't drop the ball. Please don't drop the ball. And, I mean, he obviously does the rest with the magic.
Stevie got loose. So, Andre, I'm going to tell you this too. This guy sitting next to me absolutely loves Stevie, and guess what? I got Stevie watching all the stuff.
I didn't even have a clue that he was here.
Man. What's up, man?
What's up?
S.J., what's up?
What's going on, Dre? Yeah, good Dre. To see you guys. Good to see
you, Mario, man.
Good to be on with y'all, man.
Man. Bring back the whole crew. The whole receiving corps is in the house.
That's right.
All right. Now, we talked to Dickie yesterday, bro. I talked to Dickie yesterday. I'm trying to talk to Keenan wherever he is. I hope he's watching.
Yeah,
that is awesome. Like he said, you know, Stevie's one of my favorite players. I've got to say this before we continue. I had my son, who is now 21, and he was at the game with me on that play, and that was the one game that me and him went to. And whenever you know Andre threw that pass to Stevie, and you scored that touchdown, we were going crazy, hugging, high-fiving everybody around us. I mean, I was throwing him up in the air. He was little. And then I remember as soon as the game's over and stormed the field, I got pictures of my son sitting on the goalpost after it went down. It was amazing, guys. I want to thank you guys for that memory.
Yeah, I have to admit, that was probably the loudest I've ever heard the stadium erupt.
That's awesome.
It was, it was absolutely incredible. And I know that – you know, again, the fact that we went for that play, that was a two out of three times I tried to hit Stevie on the sideline, and we managed to connect on that last one, which was, you know, for the go-ahead win.
And tell me if I'm wrong. At that point, when we got in the crunch, get the ball to 19, turned in to get the ball to 13.
Yeah,
and
I mean –
get the ball to 19, because Keenan Ball – you remember Dickie always wanted that section in the call sheet.
The number one thing from Dickie was no matter what the play was, he's always open. I mean, it's a run, he's open. It's a screen. Why did you see me? I'm in the middle of the field, open. It's the Stevie win for the game winning. But you do realize I was open on the sideline. Like, that's Dickie.
That's the competitiveness that we play with every day though at practice.
Hey.
Yeah.
Every day.
Hey.
Go ahead.
Hey, Dre, how mad was he when, after that touchdown in the Music City Bowl? How mad was Dickie because he's supposed to have been in? Dickie's supposed to have been in. He was calling because he wasn't getting the ball.
Yeah, Dickie was pretty irate. He wasn't too happy about the fact that DeMario got a touchdown.
So that's how I ended up being in the game, bro.
So, Stevie, I got to ask you this, and this is your first time coming on the show. Tell us what you've got going on, man. I know, but you've got an app, right? Is that what I hear?
Yeah, we got an app for all the coaches around the world, man. It's a great app. You know what I mean? When it comes to time and being able to communicate with your players, your parents, and ultimately your community, that league that you're in, it's like a one-stop shop for it. And you know, I only was going off the mock-up, and the official launch was this month, and now it's booming. It's booming all around, you know, and DeMario can, you know, he can add more to it, you know, as he's been working closely with the Pro Book team. Oh, yeah. But it's a special app, man, and it's helpful. That's the main thing. Absolutely. About it. It's helpful.
That sounds cool, man.
That sounds really cool. I mean, that's, yeah. I mean, honestly, you know, that's what coaches need. I mean, that's a great tool.
Exactly. You don't have to, like with me being in the coaching world now, you understand like how you have to be on top of, like, you're dealing with.
Oh, yeah, Danny. And so, I'm sorry.
Yeah. Just saying, at the end of the day, you're dealing with kids, and you want to be able to talk to the Absolutely. Parents and have an open transparency with the parents. And this app provides that.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Very cool.
That's awesome. Well, listen, guys, I know it's just really cool to sit here and have a family reunion of sorts, right? I mean, that's what this is. Yeah. And, you know, that's the uniqueness that we try to bring here at Wildcat Sports Talk. I don't know if you can see behind us, right? But these two jerseys that are down below are actually game-worn jerseys. We are crazy fans over here, all right? This was worn in 04, all right? And this one was worn in 1994, all right, when college football celebrated its 125th anniversary. So we don't play around. We've got all
three. Love it.
We're crazed fans. What's that? Do what now?
Yeah, that's a really impressive collection, fellas.
Yeah, I think DeMario's breaking up a little bit, but
I was telling them that there was Ramon back there. Ramon part of the show. Ramon Harris played basketball. He's part of the
Harris, yeah. If y'all remember Ramon, this is his game-worn NBA G League jersey.
Oh, sweet!
Yeah, that's nice. NBA championship.
That's him on our logo, by the way. That's him. He's part of the show. Like he does the Harris way. Comes on once a week, so. He's a big part of what we do and what we've tried to bring here with Wildcat Sports Talk. Our motto is that we connect you to the big blue. That's what we do. So, and again, Andre, honestly, it's been an absolute honor. Stevie, an honor. DeMario, as always.
And I got to say one thing real quick to Stevie, since we got him on here. Right after you left UK, Stevie, you came to Laurel County and did a little signing. And I was working for the newspaper there. I've been a sports writer for 20 years. But I went there to interview you and take some pictures of you doing the signing. And my son wasn't able to be with me. But I called him, and you talked to my son on the phone. And that totally made his day. And I want to tell you again, thank you for doing that.
Hey, well, yeah, I appreciate that. And just to bounce off of that, I was probably only there because of Andre Woodson. So it's kind of funny how we're all, you know, here now. You know, and that circle come around, man. That's love, though. That's sweet.
Well, you guys, I mean, I know you feel a lot of love from Big Blue Nation, but you'll never feel more love than you get from me and Adam right here at Wildcat Sports Talk. You guys are awesome.
Hey, definitely. Oh, yeah, and we're going to add DeMario into it also, because I didn't know the playbook unless DeMario taught it to me.
Hey, we already connected with DeMario. He's been on a couple times. He's our buddy, man.
Yeah.
We hope to have you back on. We hope to have you guys back on.
Yeah, it's a family.
Yeah. Yeah, we'll love that. Seriously. Oh, my God. I got so many stories about this guy, Stevie. I'd love to come back on with him.
Yeah, we need more stories.
Yeah.
Exactly right. Hey, again, Andre, seriously, thank you so much. Stevie, you guys are awesome. Listen, from a kid growing up in Kentucky, and at that time, you know, I was just fresh out of high school, man. Right. And watching you guys play was just some of the best memories I had as a Kentucky fan. And you know, those connections, you know, with between you and DeMario in that Clemson, Kentucky, you know, Music Bowl, and then of course the Stevie Got Loose that everyone across Kentucky remembers. I mean, you'll have that play forever, Stevie. They can't take that from you.
We'll have that play forever.
That's right. That's right.
They can't take anything from these guys. First of all,
That's true.
Exactly. Ever. These guys have. Gonna have some statues after a while.
There you go.
So the reason I have to show you the reason, like I told you the other day, I showed you because I couldn't do it. So it's a business deal.
That's awesome. Yeah, that's awesome. Hey, listen,
I'm gonna see the Johnson party.
Yeah, we'll definitely do this again, guys.
I'll tell you what I'm going to do as well, Stevie. If there's any way that I can help, if there's any way that I can help promote Stevie's app, he just jumped off. But DeMoria, let him know if there's any way that I can help promote him by putting a commercial. Here he is. He's back. I'll tell him. If there's any way that I can help promote you by putting on a commercial, Stevie, let me know, and I'll be glad to do it for you.
For sure.
Hey, look, we'll be in touch. We'll be in touch. We are connected now.
That's right. Hey, thank you, Andre. Thank you, Steve. Thank you, DeMario. You all take care, okay?
Thanks, guys.
It was a pleasure. Hold on. Ask him. We talked to Steve. Just before he got off, I wanted to give him that, you know, that space.
Do what?
Say it again, DeMario.
I don't know if you want to hear what I said. No, I was just saying. I know we're all a part of a lot of.
He's like, four.
And give me a few seconds to promote whatever you want, because obviously Steve got his chance. You know what I mean? So whatever, if you had something,
I just got something to promote.
Yeah, I appreciate that. Yeah, no, I don't have anything to promote. I would say. Honestly, I would love the opportunity to come back on the show and chat with you guys and bring in a couple other guests like, you know, Dickie and Raphael and Keenan and maybe even Tammy. I think it would be incredible to get this entire group together and you know, just reflect on some of the great memories we had as a unit. But certainly it's been amazing to see these two guys down here. I mean, I just saw Stevie last year and I don't think I've seen DeMario in maybe like 10 years it's been a long time. So. It's remarkable to see these guys, man. It means a lot.
And you know, Andre, here's the thing. I mean, we know Raphael.
It's been about 10 years.
So I mean, we can get a lot of those guys. So we may have to make it happen here closer to football season. We may have to have one big blow out and have all you guys.
Oh yeah, that'd be great.
Yeah, do it.
All right, we'll plan it up and we'll do it right. Again, thank you guys so much for coming on. Y'all take care and go Cats.
Go big blue.
Go Cats.
I mean, does it get any better than that?
I don't think so.
I mean, I try to tell you guys, you want to watch this.
Yeah, when we say we've got a big surprise, we've got a big surprise.
I mean, we got a huge surprise.
That was amazing, man.
That was awesome.
It brought back memories to me and be able to hear those guys talk about it. It was amazing.
Hey, guys, so coming up after the break, we're going to teach you. Well, I'm not going to teach you, but we got a couple of guys that are going to teach you a way that you can change your life. I mean, we're going to show you how to change your life. We're going to let you see former quarterbacks Andre Woodson and Jalen Whitlow. Oh, yeah, and by the way, Andre threw to DeMario Ford. He was on the show. Stevie Got Loose is one of the best plays of all time. And guess what? He was on the show. I mean, I submit, it just doesn't get any better than that. That's just it. So.
And Josh, you're very welcome, man. Glad you enjoyed that.
That's right. Hey, don't forget, Donovan Storm's got you covered. Home, auto, life, motorcycle, workman's comp. He's got it all of them, okay? And he's located in Corbin next to L&N Federal Credit Union in the Union Plaza Shopping Center. We'll be back right after this. You're listening to Big Blue Nation's Best Kept Secret. That's right. We are Wildcat Sports Talk.
Looking for a new phone or to repair your old device? Go see them over at One Stop Phone Shop. That's right. They can literally save you hundreds of dollars on a new device or to repair your old device. Now, everything they do on site, whether it be Android or iPhone repairs, are usually within 1 hour. Stop by today. See them over in Middlesboro, located at 1507 Highway 25 in Middlesboro, Kentucky. You can also give them a call. Call them up 606-302-7005.
Do more. Enjoy more. Expect more from your internet experience. Kinetic by Windstream is delivering enhanced speed and reliability for homes and businesses around the country. We've made major investments in our network in your community. We're lighting the way to advanced capabilities and more opportunities. Stream seamlessly, surf securely, game victoriously, and connect to great offers for work or home at Windstream.com.
If you're thinking about making the switch to Windstream, you can do it today. That's right. Just $37 a month and you'll get the fast internet you've been dreaming of. And the best part, you sign up with me, you're going to get a $100 credit and 30 days to try it out risk-free. No money down. What have you got to lose? Call me today, 606-309-1673. And let me set you up. That's 606-309-1673.
We the people are guaranteed five freedoms in the First Amendment.
Freedom of speech.
Freedom of religion.
Freedom of the press.
Freedom to peaceably assemble.
Freedom to petition the government.
Only the United States has these five freedoms so simply bound together and guaranteed. Think first. Learn more at thinkfirstamendment.org.
Wash your hands, stay home, cover your cough. It's our new reality with COVID-19. Physicians and public health professionals are trying to protect us because our healthcare system would be overwhelmed if too many people get seriously ill. We have to take their advice seriously. So, prepare, focus on the essentials. Protect, keep some space from people outside your home, and disinfect a lot. Get the facts at kycovid19.ky.gov. Prepare, protect, disinfect.
Welcome back to Wildcat Sports Talk. I don't know, I've got all sorts of stuff going on over here. There we are. Thank you guys so much for tuning in to Big Blue Nation's Best Kept Secret. Make sure you're sharing this all over the place. Bobby, you'll have to go back and watch, buddy. You missed a crazy good show.
Yeah. If anybody's just tuning in, make sure to finish it, but go back and watch the rest, the early part.
All right. So, and I know we this is not necessarily like something we're known for, but the thing is, so I'm going to give you a little bit of backstory. I work with a gentleman. His name is James. He's a great guy. And he has a way that can change all of our lives.
Okay.
I'm telling you.
For the better, of course.
For the better. Yes.
Well, I think we all want to hear that.
For the better. James, now, listen, you know Ramon, obviously. We've talked about this several times. First of all, how you doing, man? Do you have a good day today?
I'm great. Oh, man, you know I killed it out in the field, as always. I'm great, man. Can you hear me okay?
I haven't looked lately, but, I mean, I'm sure you put up a good, 20, right?
You got it. Yeah, man, how y'all doing, man? Awesome. I just seen the segue, man. You all did awesome, man. Good energy. Good vibes going on right now.
Hey, man, we appreciate that. Like, you know, We didn't
want to give you an easy act to follow.
Yeah,
exactly. Yeah. There you go. I mean,
you're following three legends. You're following Andre Johnson. You're following Andre Johnson. Andre Woodson. You're following Stevie Johnson, and you're following DeVoria Ford. Hey, I got my words jumbled. Leave me alone.
Awesome. No problem, man.
Tell us about we got Adam backstage. Tell us about him.
Yeah, man. So Adam, I met that guy a few years ago, actually. Back in 2017, I got into the investing space. And of course, you know, when I find something great, I share the opportunity. So I was on social media sharing it, and I ran across this guy. He was doing the exact same thing that I was doing, you know, educating and putting people onto something that's potentially going to change their situation that they're currently in. So I linked with the guy, man, a shout out, a message, humble guy. Door was open right away. We connected. I mean, and it's been up from there, man. He's a great guy, man.
All right. So I'm going to give you kind of just a few minutes. You'll have the floor. Kind of tell us what it's all about. Tell us what it is. Tell us how a guy like me sitting over here in Southeast Kentucky can change my life right here in this holler.
Absolutely, man. So simple, man. Many people are looking for other vehicles that they can plug into besides their, you know, their normal 9-to-5 or whatever they may have going on. We're always looking for, you know, that extra, right? So in this space, this is the foreign exchange market. Forex is short for foreign exchange market. What we're able to do right away with this company that I'm about to announce, able to plug in and have our money compound and grow every single day. And I don't know how many people out there know, but compound interest is the eighth wonder of the world. People that know it, they get rich from it. And it's just that simple. So what this company allows you to do, not only can they educate you, they have a platform where you can plug in and get the education and the knowledge, take tests just to make sure, of course, you're retaining the information. But while you're doing that, you're able to take your money that you have in a savings account or what have you, and attach it to an AI software that trades your money in the Forex market. Now, this has been tested. They've been running this since February of last year. It hasn't had one losing day, and it's averaging 37% ROI per month, return on investment, which is, that's mind blown, right? People have savings accounts, and most people know that a savings account, they give you a return. They give you an annual return. It's very, very small. So if you're able to put your money instead of a savings account into a broker account and attach it to a software that's compounding and growing your money every single day, that's powerful. So that's what this company allows you to do, man. It's awesome. I shared it with Adam. And of course, from day one, he jumped into the highest package that you can come in at. And he's allowing his money to work for him. I've been involved with the company since January. In January, we did 70% ROI. So everybody in the company that attached to the same software that I was attached to, they grew their account 70%.
Now, that's incredible. You know,
it is, man. And it's hard to wrap your mind around it, that something out there is, you know, you're able to get access to something like this. That's why I'm sharing the opportunity. That's why Adam's sharing the opportunity. So, it's a lot more to it, man. It's a lot more to it. You can learn how to manually trade, you know, you learn all about the ins and outs of the foreign exchange market. It's not stocks. People get that confused all the time. It's not stocks. It's Forex, foreign exchange. Well, yeah, that's just a quick overview, man.
Yeah, so that's great. Let's let Adam weigh in for a second. Are you there?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Can you guys hear me?
Yeah, can hear you great. Okay. Great.
All right. Awesome.
So kind of give us your rundown, basically kind of shadowing what he said and tell, I mean, it's worked for you. So, look, it's worked for just about everybody, hasn't it?
Absolutely. So first of all, I want to say shout out to you guys. Big shout out to James. This is actually our second round, right? He actually introduced me to Forex, several years ago. I knew nothing about it. He grabbed me up, man. It was like, yo, you need to be a part of this, man. This is something special. So, we had got our first round taste of it with a company. It didn't really work out as the way we wanted to. And that's why this is so special. This particular situation is, you can make it as passive as you want, right? So for busy people like myself, who work a day job, I got a 2-year-old, you know, I have a wife, you know, I have all the things, right, to keep you busy. This thing was perfect for me because you literally, it's a set it and forget it type situation. And, you know, every entrepreneur looks for those type of vehicles, right? And when I see opportunities like that, I don't waste time. I tell people I'm probably one of the guys who, I'm when I want to make a decision, I make it quick, right? Because I'm a believer that time wasted is money wasted. So when James told me about this, man, I went in with the highest package, like you said, and I've been loving it ever since. I have no regrets.
That's awesome. That's awesome. Now, people looking for something very turnkey in today's society, this is something that would definitely fit into that category. And what I would say to that is, so there's folks out there, they're listening. How can they get more information? Where do they need to go to? Who do they need to contact? Give them that really quick before we have to, you know, we're running out of time.
Absolutely, man. So on this video, and I'll put my name in the comments so that way you all can go and add me, James Johnson, on Facebook, and Adam as well. You can add us on Facebook. Everything is there. We're 100% transparent. I'm able to go and, you know, go into Manifest. You're able to go to into the site and pick which package you're comfortable with. You know, everybody doesn't have the same amount to invest and get started. So pick the package that you're comfortable with. See how it works. You know, once you get those gains and that profit, then of course you can upgrade to a higher package. But, you know, just get your feet wet. Do your own due diligence. That's one thing I will say. You know, take something away from this. Do your research, because obviously if we're sharing it, it must be something special, right? So Manifest, you're going to hear this for many years to come. Your grandkids, your kids' kids, everybody is going to be able to really win from this from day one. Education is key, and that's one thing we focus on, okay? So, yeah, just add us as a friend. If you send me a message, I may have to go into the private, you know, the private section and make sure I accept it. So just give me some time to get back to you. But, yeah, man, I appreciate the opportunity, Adam. You know, always showing love. I appreciate your support, brother.
Most definitely. Most definitely.
And also, too, I just wanted to throw this out there as well. He doesn't even realize this half the time, but guys named Adam are the coolest dudes on earth. I mean, I've heard this.
I swear to say, I'm not sure we can handle Adams on one show.
I've heard this about thousands of times. I'm just telling you, I read it in an article, so it has to be true.
Man, so it's true, man. It's true.
Like it is.
About to that.
guys, thank you so much.
Yeah, we do appreciate you guys coming on and sharing that with us.
No problem at all. Thank you all for having us.
Yep, y'all take care.
Appreciate you all, man. All right. You too, man.
All right. There you go. Wildcat Sports Talk.
Now that's how you put a little bit of everything.
Brings a little bit of everything to every show. That's just what we do. That's how we roll. Thank you guys so much for tuning in on 106.3, The Big One. We're going to talk all about the SEC tournament this week. We kind of left that out.
Yeah. We mentioned that we're going to be there.
We're going to be there. And by the way, yes, Adam did bite the apple, but only after Eve asked him to. I'm just saying. So anyway, Tim?
Yeah, I mean, that's it. I don't know what to say after that show, except for that was one of my favorite shows ever. And if anybody you know wasn't watching that show, or if you missed the beginning of it,
we're not friends with you anymore.
Well,
I'm just kidding.
Go back and watch it. Tell everybody.
I was just kidding, Tim.
Oh, okay. I didn't know. You never know with you.
I was joking.
Kind of mean.
I'm not mean. I'm actually a really good guy.
I'm the nice one. You're the mean one.
I don't know. I just, you know,
but
guys like me, man.
So the next time we come on the show, we're going to be in Nashville.
We are. Yeah, absolutely. Well, you know, unless you're listening on 106.3, The Big One, and then next time we come on the show, we're going to talk more. Every show, every week over in Pineville is going to be a different flavor. We thought that this one would be perfect for you guys. So again,
we had to make sure we got this to you guys.
Thank you guys so much. We'll be in Nashville. Go Cats. Win by a million. Yep. Let's get it. Let's get into the NCAA tournament and do all that stuff.
Yeah. Love you guys, and go Big Blue.
Love you guys. Take care. You've been listening to Big Blue Nation's best kept secret. We are Wildcat Sports Talk. Take care. Your daddy works.